the uniqueness of Domaine Origiro is the traceability on oak, because we are working with the Argonne forest, the local forest, 70 kilometers away from here. And you can see that we have a geolocalization of the trees. Here it's the tree number 916 from Chatrice. And for example, let's say here we have Argonne Beaulieu, another terroir of the forest. It's the same as the terroir for vines. We are working with terroirs, territories, clima for oak, for the staves. And we have a traceability from the tree to the barrel, because our chef de cave, Sébastien Le Golvet, goes in the heart of the forest to handpick the trees while they are still on. And so we can have a geolocalization. This is how it comes here. And here, for example, we have the tree 951, and here 951 as well. So from a tree of 200 years old, we only got two barrels. And then when the tree is done, it will be sliced into staves, and the staves will be dried and seasoned for 3 years outside. You can see that it has been sliced into staves in August 15, and then the barrel was made in August 18, just before. And you can see here is the first juice of the Vendemia, the harvest 18, put it into the barrel the 29th of August 18. And here the wines will stay 11 months on the oak for the alcoholic fermentation, malolactic fermentation over full lees. Here you have to imagine that we are working solely with new oak, with this traceability, with this geolocalization. And the vin clair of Champagne are very fine, very delicate, and we have to be very careful not to have an oak juice, but to have the perfect match and perfect harmony between the terroir of Ailly Grand Cru and the terroir of the Argonne oak. Harvest 2018 was very rich, very dense, so we have been working a lot with Chatrice, that brings a lot of minerality, angle, and the pencil sharp, so it gives a little punch to the juice. And when we have an harvest that is lacking a bit of the ripeness and the richness, then we work with other terroirs that will bring density, roundness. In the Argonne forest, the trees grow very, very slowly, so they are very dense. And so when we put the juices into the barrels, into the new oak, it's very respectful, very well in harmony, because there is not that much exchange of tannins between the oak and the juice. Again, it's very fine, very delicate. That's why Argonne oak is the best to match with the Vin Clair of Champagne. It's the local forest, but it's the best because we've tried all the French forest before seeing and putting as an evidence that Argonne oak was the perfect match and the best match. Stone eggs made from Genoa in Italy. So it's called grès. It's clay, so argile, clay, plus kaolin. Argile and kaolin, that makes grès, sandstone. And you can see it has been heated at 1200 Celsius degrees. So inside it creates almost like a vitrification, like a porcelain. Mm-hmm. So it's reductive, there is not that much oxygen compared than in the barrels. We have been looking for the past 25 years for an alternative to stainless steel. We believe stainless steel at Chaillot is good for beer, for milk, not for fine wines. And this is why we've been looking for small containers. We started with concrete, then we moved to terracotta from Impruneta in Tuscany. Mm-hmm. And then now the sandstone eggs are from Genoa, 600 liters. And what is important is the shape, so that the nice and good lees are always into suspension, into the egg to give intensity of aromas, creaminess, and it's also an antioxidant, so we use less and less sulfites. And in the vineyard, we work as natural as possible. We are working with old vines. We are working, the whole vineyard is covered with grass, so we don't use any weed killers. We don't use any fungicide, any anti-rotten, because we are cutting leaves on the sun rising part, so that there is a nice wind to avoid the botrytis, and also it creates a little sunburn on the grapes, on the berries, so that the skin will be quite thicker, more resistant. And no herbicide, no fungicide, and no insecticide, because we use what is called the sexual confusion with the rack of pheromones. So here with the dégrafeur, the idea is to go in between the neck of the bottle and the agraffe, and you go up and down like that.
Shall I go there?